There's nothing quite so satisfying as creating ornaments for display in your home or on your Christmas tree. Today I'm going to show you how to create these Tiffany-style glass ornaments using clear glass eggs and balls, alcohol ink, and a few other supplies. What you see here is the progression from the ornament as it comes from the package right through to the finished piece. And let me show you, we're going to break this down into some really easy steps, how to go from here to here. So the first thing you need to do, these ornaments start out clear, but having said that, alcohol inks are transparent. If you put transparent inks on something that's clear, you're not going to see them. So the solution is to put some white paint inside, and that process is really simple. What you need to do is remove the hanger and this little cover piece from the ornament. I'm using distress paint because it's multi-surface, so I know that it's going to go ahead and stick to the glass. I'm not going to have any adhering problems, and that bottle is almost empty, so I'm going to grab one that has more in it. If you want the best results, you should plan on putting two separate coats inside your eggs. That's going to give you more of an opaque white surface on the inside for the alcohol inks to contrast against. So what you're going to do is pour a bunch of paint inside the egg or the ball shape. I have both here that I'm working with. It just happens to be an egg. And you're going to turn this until the entire inside is coated. This is not rocket science. It's pretty easy stuff. Now, actually, I'm turning toward me, and I know you can't see all that much, but basically, I'm just running the paint around the inside until this is completely coated. What I can do, if I need to, is go ahead and shake this down. And this is actually going to take a little bit more paint. Sometimes it's easier to just put more in there and then let it drain out afterward, rather than taking a little bit of paint and trying to get it to roll around the inside of the ornament. All right, so that looks pretty good now. I'm just going to turn this, and you can see that there's the last of it right there, and I'm just waiting for the paint to come down and coat the inside. So I would let this dry completely, and depending on humidity and temperature and all that good stuff is going to really factor into how long it's going to take for this to dry. Just trying to get the last bit of that coated. All right, so now what I'm going to do is turn that upside down and wipe the paint off my finger. So back to dry time. It's going to be affected by humidity, by temperature, by lots of different things. It's winter time, obviously, as we're near to Christmas as I film this, so it's probably going to take 5 or 6 hours. What I would do would be to let the bulk of the paint drip out, and then obviously I don't want to tie up my bottle completely, just letting paint drip off. So then I would take an egg and I would turn it, these are just washi tape, I would turn it upside down over a piece of paper, and you might get 2 or 3 drops, and it might take a period of 4 or 5 hours for that to dry. And then I would do the same thing again. I would come back and put another coat in there. Once your paint is dry, then you can start wiping off the outside of the egg. You'll notice this, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little bit of kind of smudgy black stuff on there. You want to clean that all off. If you need to, use some 91% alcohol and wipe down the outside of the egg so you're starting with a nice clean surface. Once you've got your second coat on, you're going to pop the hanger and this little camouflage piece that goes on the top back in, and then it's time to start adding the alcohol inks. When I do these eggs, I tend to choose darker colors of alcohol ink. I find that they give you better results. Light colors, because they're so light, because they're so transparent, and they're on that white background, sometimes they don't show up real well, so I've chosen to more or less stick with the darker ones. Now, I'm using Rangers. This is the replacement felt for the alcohol ink blending tool, but I like to use this is the 1-inch round ink blending tool, so what I do is I just take these and I cut them so that I have a piece that mostly fits on there. It's going to overhang a little bit, but I'm not real worried about that one way or the other. Now, what I have found as I play with this is that sometimes it's better to put on a layer of color and maybe do a little bit of dabbing, and then you come back and you can layer more color on top of it. And one of the things that you'll find as you go along is that the more ink you have on this piece of felt or whatever you're using to apply it, the more spread you're going to get, the bigger the area of ink you're going to get. So in the beginning, when this tends to be fairly wet, you're going to find that you have to control how much spread you get, and that'll make more sense kind of as we go along. The one thing that I will tell you, if you get stuff on here and you decide you just don't like it, stop what you're doing, grab a piece of paper towel and some alcohol, wipe it all off, and start from scratch. Just let that alcohol completely evaporate off of the egg, and then you can start all over again. So it's not like you're ever committed to the point where you can't go back. You can just start from scratch. Now, we've got a fair amount of area to cover here, so I am going to use a reasonable amount of ink. Now, having said that, I just mentioned that a lot of ink means it's going to spread, and so I'm going to show you how to kind of mitigate that. And it's as simple as kind of blowing on things. Really, that's all you have to do, and that stops the spread a little bit. So to get that kind of Tiffany look, let me just bring this back in. And this does remind me of a Tiffany lamp where you have, typically you have some kind of an ornate top piece with all the different colors and pieces. I start by putting color on the entire egg, and that's how I'm going to get this kind of mottled effect in the center. So I want to keep my hands pretty much off the egg, and that means I'm going to work on a clean piece of paper, and I'm going to hold the egg or the ornament, whatever it is, by this neck. And then I'm just going to start blending color on here initially. The nice thing about alcohol inks is that you have to work really hard to make a muddy mess, and so the likelihood that you're going to do that is pretty slim, but alcohol is your best friend. It means you can always come back and you can clean it off. Now, once I get color kind of all over everything is when I like to go back and start stroking. Now, what you can see as you watch this color, see how you get lines and then they sort of spread out and they smooth out? That has a lot to do with how much alcohol ink there is on this applicator tool. If there were less, then there would be a lot less of that going on. So I kind of do this until I'm satisfied with the way that it looks. And what does that mean? Well, it means that at this point, I kind of like what I've got and I know that I can progress on to the next steps from there. Now, if I think this has gotten real blue, and it really has, I can just kind of set this down for a second. Hopefully it won't roll off. And I'm going to come and I'm going to put some more of the pink on here. I like to start on the bottom because if I'm going to have a lot of spread, it's easier to deal with it on the bottom, or at least that's what I find. So I'm just going to start tapping. Now what I want you to notice is how much spread happens. Now what I want you to notice, I'm going to shut my mouth and I'm going to blow on this once I tap it, and you'll see that I can control that spread rather than getting a big smooth blob like that. Eventually, I want to get little tiny discrete dots like what you see here, and the key to that is twofold. The first one is less ink or ink that started to dry out, and to blow on it. So if I come in here and I tap and I blow on this, see how I've controlled that so that it hasn't gotten really big? And that's how you can start to play with this. Now, to lay in the color initially, I'm not too worried, and you watch this pattern as it grows. It goes from being little tiny dots and it grows to something bigger. So I'm going to get my color in there by doing this initially. And I kind of just eyeball this to make certain that I've got color kind of in the same place all the way around. Now, one of the things that you'll see me do is to turn this tool, because I don't want the pattern of the ink as it's on that piece of felt, I don't want that to be repeated all the time and suddenly I have something that looks samey-samey. Now again, this was really wet, so I'm not getting a lot of discrete dots. Once this is dry, I don't want to set this down on this piece of paper because you can see I've already got some stuff on here. Once this is dry, I'm going to come in. Now you'll notice that I've got felt hanging off the edge of the applicator. That's deliberate. That's going to allow me to get up in here into the neck of this ornament and get color in there nice and tight. I don't care what the pattern looks like now, I just want to get that color in there. So now I'm going to start tapping, and this is where I'm probably going to have to come back with a different piece of felt once I get my main color on here, and that'll allow me to come back. And you can see that I have, what's happened here is I didn't let that dry enough, so that's rubbed off, but I can fix that. I'm not real worried about that. Anyway, I'm going to probably come back with another piece of felt that's going to allow me to get more of that very definite patterning and less of this kind of big, soft, blobby look. If you want big, soft, blobby look, then that's easy. Getting the discrete dots requires a little bit more technique. None of it is difficult. It's just knowing how the alcohol inks behave and what you have to do to make them do what you want them to do. All right, so that looks pretty good. I don't know that I necessarily want to go much further down than that. So now that I know that this is dry, I'm just going to come and lightly start tapping color back in there. And obviously there's a difference between you doing this at home and me doing this on camera, trying to show you how to do it. All right, so I've covered up what got taken off. Now what I need to do is let this dry. So I'm going to do that well, I didn't really want to set it there. Let me just hold it. I'm going to let this dry. I'm going to get a clean piece of felt, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how we can add a little, like I said, a little bit more discrete dots so we get that fine pattern rather than just that big one like you see here. The ink on the ornament is dry now, and I've got a clean piece of felt on my applicator. This time I think what I'm going to do, since there's a lot of turquoise in here, I think I'm going to emphasize the pink and the green. So I will put some of those on here, probably more on the pink and a little less on the green, only because there's still some green in here. Now again, I have a fair amount of ink on there. I can stamp some of this off if I want. That will help prevent getting, again, this spread. But I'm going to probably not talk because I'm going to blow on this, and that'll help control the spread. So I'm going to tap, probably blow, and then tap again. And I'm also using a really light touch when I tap. I just want to put a little tiny bit of ink on there. I think that's too much. I can tap some of it off. Just kind of push that felt back on there. Now I'm going to handle this egg as little as possible in this area, because the oils from your fingers will absolutely affect the alcohol ink. So if I need to come back and touch the bottom up, I will. Now I'm going to do the same thing up here, again with a really light touch, and I just want to put some of this color on here, and you can see that I'm getting pretty small dots. I can again control that size by going ahead and blowing on them, which I will do, and I will stop talking so I can do it. This is the process. Honestly, it isn't any more complicated than this. If you wanted to cover this entire ornament with all of this kind of patterning, you could certainly do that. I kind of liked this streaky stuff in the middle, but this is it. You can do this with kids. You can do this yourself. You can have an ornament making party with your buddies or your neighbors or whatever it is that you want to do. We will have the ornaments. Obviously, we always have alcohol ink, so we'll have plenty of that. And then the final step, once you are satisfied with this, and I'm not yet, but once you're satisfied with it, the final step is to put some kind of a clear coat on it, because again, over the years you're going to handle this and the ink will come off eventually. So I'm using Krylon's Crystal Clear, don't say that five times fast, Krylon's Crystal Clear. You put this on in a spray, do it someplace where it's warm enough so that the spray will work, but you don't want to do this indoors, it's a little whiffy. I use things like, let me bring this one in. This is one I have going. I use things like skewers, and I will line these up like this to let them dry, and I will also take them out to the garage, which is not nearly as cold as it is outside, and I will spray them lightly on the sides and kind of around, and then I'll come back and do another coat. With these kinds of things, it's much better to put a couple of light coats on than it is to put one heavy, ugly, drippy coat. You don't ever want to go there. And then from here, you can use a regular hanger, you can use some pretty ribbon, you can use whatever you want, and you have this really nice selection of really pretty ornaments that you can put on your tree, that you can give as gifts, or you can do anything you want with.